Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside of theuptrend.com with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, March 25th, 2008. Looking at the daily market consensus summary from Monday's close, we can see we had strength across the board in the U.S. markets and some weakness in the energy sector. Now, in the pre-market this morning, we've got S&P futures up 6.7, NASDAQ futures up 9.5, and the Dow futures up 54. So we are looking for a flat to slightly higher open on Tuesday morning. Now, looking at the major ETFs, we can see that while the market has been going up the past couple of days, and the NASDAQ was up quite strongly yesterday, volume has continued to drop. So here's the cues for the NASDAQ 100, and here's the SPIDRs, the major ETF for the S&P 500. You'll see that the volume was lower on Monday than it was on Thursday. And looking at the iShares for the TSX 60, representing the Canadian market, we can see that the volume was down dramatically on Monday, even though the market was higher. So this makes me very suspicious of this up move, and be looking for it to end very, very soon now. Now, one of the major sectors that we're keeping an eye on right now is the U.S. financial sector, and one of the easiest ways to do that is to look at the XLF, the SPIDR Financial ETF. Now, yesterday it ran up to the bottom of the flypaper channel, which is where it has run up to many times in the past, and found resistance at that point. But one of the couple of the major things you need to take away from Monday's activity was, first of all, we actually closed near the open of the day, and even though the market ran higher during the day, we actually came back and closed near the low of the day, which is not a bullish sign. And also, volume was down dramatically from last week and down below the 20-day moving average of volume. So even though technically we were up over 1% yesterday, it was on lighter volume, and we actually reversed and closed near the low of the day. So there was a lot of selling into yesterday's buying. Not a positive sign. So I don't have a lot of confidence in this up move, and I think it's going to be over very, very quickly. Now let's look at some 60-minute charts. We posted this 60-minute chart yesterday morning, and we were looking at possible resistance at this downtrend line, and then if that didn't hold, then resistance at the flypaper channel. And during the day, the market made it up to the flypaper channel and stopped. So for Tuesday's market activity, we're going to be looking for an hourly close on the TSX below 12,950 to tell us that this current uptrend is over. Now the futures for crude oil and for gold are up in the pre-market this morning, so I am looking for the TSX to at least open higher on Tuesday morning. So we looked at this chart for the S&P 500 yesterday. This is the 60-minute chart, 60-minute panic zone chart. And what we were looking at yesterday was the possibility that the market could move its way up into either the bottom or the top of this open gap here that was formed. And you'll see that that's clustering the 1360 area. So we were looking for a move up there as a possible area to top. And that's exactly what the market did. It moved right up into the open gap and stopped. Now we are projecting higher up into the 1380 area, so we could certainly move up there. But what we're going to be looking for over our shoulder on Tuesday is an hourly close below 1339 on the S&P 500 to tell us that this current intraday uptrend is over. Now on the NASDAQ, we looked at this chart yesterday, and what we were looking at was the major resistance that we had right across here at the 2281 area. And we were looking at the fact that if we broke out above that, then we'd be moving up to 2312 and then 2343. And up at 2343, you see we had a little cluster right here just below 2343. And that's exactly where the market moved up to yesterday. Didn't make it up to 2343, got up to as high as 2336, which was right into that open cluster of resistance. And that's exactly where we stopped yesterday. So on Tuesday, we're going to be looking for a close below 2290 on the NASDAQ to tell us that this current uptrend is over. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. I don't have a lot of confidence in this move higher. It's on lower and lower volume. It looks like a lot of churning, a lot of short covering, and I would imagine a lot of window dressing by mutual funds right now, trying to reposition themselves going into the end of a very, very bad quarter for the mutual fund industry. And that doesn't give me a lot of confidence. So, you know, could we possibly hold this current sort of uptrend status into the week, end of the week, end of the month? Yeah, I think so. And then I think the selling is going to start to start again next week. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning. We'll talk to you again this Wednesday morning.